We are big on sports.
Definitely game on, and we are certainly big on sports. It's Game On Fun Friday. Welcome to the show. For the next 1 hour, the biggest stories in the world of sports, including we'll take you through all the results from last night. There was football across the English Premier League, the Spanish La Liga as well. And action in Spain does get returned later this evening. Atletico Madrid will be up against Mallorca. Games will be running through the rest of the weekend. And the crunch time, we'll see the club side Barcelona heading away to Villarreal. And they'll need 3 points, especially in the quest to stay in the running for the Spanish La Liga. But there's plenty of football across the English Premier League. The same goes for the Italian Serie A as well. But on the show as well, we should be joined by a guest in just a bit, and we shall be talking nothing but Ugandan football and precisely what he's been up to, especially during the COVID-19 lockdown. So stick around for that coming through in just a bit. But do remember, we don't want to hear from you. So any highlights, any predictions for the games coming through this weekend, listen up, guys. Head down to social media, Facebook, Urban Television, Twitter. The handle is at Urban TV Uganda. The number is 0414-337-872. You can certainly get to give us that call and pick some of your highlights and definitely your reactions as well. But that being said, welcome, it's Game On Fun Friday. My name is Brian Asimwe. I'll be joined by Diego Nsubuga and certainly Sharon Adong for the next 1 hour as well. How are you doing, guys, and welcome to the show?
I'm doing good.
Diego, today you decided to look almost like me.
But I can see you, that shirt of yours.
Someone might think we have
like
the same designer.
One of your grandpa.
But Diego, is that... are you sure? Your eyes are okay, because this is very nice test, my friend.
Yeah, even your grandpa is true.
I think Sharon will be the better judge, because women have an eye for fashion. Sharon, tell us.
I actually think he even just took his young brother's shirt.
I can see
all
this.
My identity.
By the way, I'm mourning. That's why she's in black.
Why are you speaking for me? You have come with too much fire. Fire on the mountain. Come on, relax.
Is it bad to mourn, though?
No, it's not bad to mourn, but he's not my spokesperson. The last time I told you on air, I said I haven't yet appointed my spokesperson. So he's trying to appoint himself.
But no.
But if you notice, he's doing a very good job of speaking for you.
I'll rather appoint Becky to be my spokesperson. Abachara Simira team.
Becky to be your spokesperson?
Yeah.
Ah, she best. Can't.
She can. She can attract everyone.
Actually, that one, I'm positive.
Alice, guys, how is the week been? Diego, I'll start with you. Quite the eventful week it's been in terms of sports. Walking into another action-packed weekend as well. Any highlights for you?
Just the death of the sports person, and that is Brigadier at Sherry Jackson Bell.
Definitely very sad, and I've seen the tributes coming right from FUFA at the very top, the entire football fraternity. His contribution and service, the game has got to be something quite immense.
We've lost such a guy, because himself alone, he was the financier of the Victors FC, and a team that never failed to represent the country when it comes to continent twice. 2007-08, they won Uganda Cup, then 2011, and they also won Uganda Cup, and they never failed. They did fail to represent the country in the Cup competitions, as other clubs did.
Definitely, may he so rest in peace. Sharon, how are you doing? A big week in terms of sports. Any highlights for you?
Yes, I'm doing fine. Of course, still in a sober mood mourning. A comrade. Why I call a comrade, you know, when you're once from that family, that lineage of that profession. So definitely, you also become a comrade in making, you know. Well, my highlights, Jose Mourinho continuing crying. You know, at times when you cheat people, when you mistreat people, God does not sleep. I remember one time when Jose Mourinho told Wenger that Wenger is the master of failures. He's a specialist in failure. So they say he who laughs last, laughs best.
Wenger said you are a checkbook manager.
Yeah, he's a checkbook manager. But now, the English football has twisted its tongues. It's no more about paying check whatsoever. That was an illusion But, you know, for me, why I say it's my highlight, Mourinho has been rampage. She's been going on all officials, his colleagues in England. Mm. But again, at the same time, saying you'd rather do without having Michael Oliver in the pitch, because Michael Oliver seems to be no more of a referee he expected.
If you look at that goal, the Tottenham fans will feel a bit undone, because, you know, someone is going to the ground. Obviously, the ball hits the hand. It's a reflex. But again, the VAR clearly comes out after a majority of the reviews. They're saying, listen, this one should not be able to stand. So that is the game of football. If you feel like a right goal has been cancelled, how about you score at the right
yeah,
one?
Yeah, you see, that's what I'm saying. When you cheat people, when you talk bad about people, God will always pay you back with also tears. I mean, there's a time when VAR was just introduced in the world of football. I mean, our own David De Boer said VAR should not actually, be used in football, because it's killing the beautiful game. It's killing the flair and the beauty of the game and the love of the game. And now today you see coaches worldwide, administrators crying left, right, center. But for me, I don't feel pity for Jose Mourinho.
Definitely, we'll be coming back to that. First things first, let's look at the fixtures in the Spanish La Liga, because games get returned later this evening at the Wanda Metropolitano. Atletico Madrid will be hoping to go 5 points ahead of fourth place Sevilla, where they do get World Cup Mallorca. And certainly games will be returning for the rest of the weekend. Tomorrow, Celta Vigo take on Real Betis. But Real Valladolid will be up against Alaves in Spain. Granada will take on Valencia. And then on Sunday, Atletico Bilbao will take on Real Madrid. Meanwhile, for Real Madrid, certainly they are now 4 points clear following that 1-0 win against Getafe last night. Espanyol, I'll be up against Leganes. Osasuna will take on Getafe. Villarreal will be up against Barcelona. That is the big game. And then on Monday, Levante will take on Real Sociedad. Sevilla will be up against Eibar. Guys, first things first, some big games in Spain, because you're thinking for Barcelona, they'll need that win. Otherwise, they're giving the title to Real Madrid with 5 games left to go. Atletico as well need that win to stay third in the league.
I tell you what, the situation Barcelona are in now is so worrying. That you don't know which game they are going to win, which game they are going to lose. But Real Madrid being ahead of them, 4 points?
4 points, yes.
4 points clear? Mm. I just know that it's like a sedan deal. Because when you look at the way Barcelona is playing, first of all, now players are against their manager. That is
Kiki Setien.
And they are against his tactics. They are questioning it. Mm. That means the players... it seems like the players they are doing the role that would have been done by the coach. Mm. Instead of them playing the games or playing football, they are just questioning the coach's tactics. Just know there is a problem. And when Madrid, they are about 4 points clear against above Barcelona. Mm. Just know it is almost a done deal.
Here's the interesting thing, Sharon. I look at Barcelona and Real Madrid. Some will say none of them wants to win the league title, because they've both had very poor performances over the course of the entire season. The difference is, ever since the La Liga came back, Real Madrid have found a way of scrapping and picking up 3 points. Barcelona, though, they drew against Sevilla, they drew against Celta Vigo last week. They can't seem to win games.
You see, they always say the end justifies the means. And much as people say, allude to the fact that these two teams, especially Real Madrid and Barcelona, did not have quite a very good start of the season. But again, as they went on ahead, Barcelona showed again to be more of weak than Real Madrid. You've just alluded to the fact that they drew 3 consecutive games. Now, in a crucial game where you're having two bulls competing together, and then one bull slides 1 or 2 steps, and then the bull takes forward, definitely it becomes an advantage for them. Now, already you have Barcelona, which is having a problem with Setien, who happens to be the manager. And then probably you would also say the squad, much as Messi is still scoring his goal, making the 700th goal, of course, still not better than Cristiano Ronaldo if you want to compare of this generation. So for me, I think it's just wounds in the camp of Barcelona. They just need to give up and just move forward and build forward to looking forward to next season. Otherwise, the ball is already rolling in the courts of Real Madrid, and that is where it is right now.
All right, 5 games left to go in now. The Spanish La Liga, this is how the table stands. Real Madrid are 4 points clear on 74 points. Barcelona are second on 70 points. Atletico Madrid are in third place on 9 points. They are 2 points ahead of fourth place Sevilla. In fifth place, you've got Villarreal knocking on the doors for Champions League football on 54 points. Getafe are sixth. They've had an outstanding campaign. They're on 52 points. In seventh place is Real Sociedad on 50 points. You've got Atletico Bilbao in eighth place. In ninth place, you've got Valencia. Granada are currently 10th on 46 points. Osasuna are down in 11th on 44 points. Levante are 12th on 42. Real Betis are 13th. Real Valladolid are 14th. Alaves are 15th. Aiba are sitting 16th on 35 points. And then you've got the club side, Celta Vigo, 5 points outside the drop zone on 34 points. In the relegation dogfight, you've got Mallorca. There's Leganes and certainly Espanyol who are rock bottom down in Spain. Say, there you go. That is a bit of football to look out for quickly. Away from that, the Serie A does get returned. Juventus face off against Torino this weekend. Sassuolo take on Lecce. Lazio will be up against AC Milan as well. Inter Milan on Saturday will take on Bologna. Brescia will be up against Verona. You've got Cagliari taking on Atlanta. Palma will be up against Fiorentina in Italy. Spal will be away to Sampdoria. And then certainly the club side, Udinese, will take on Genoa before Napoli take on Roma. But listen up, guys. Right now, joining us on the show, we've got Africa's number one goalkeeper, also the Uganda Cranes captain. He's a six-time PSL champion down in South Africa, the 2016 African best of the African continent. You could go on and on. His name is Dennis Onyango, and Masindo Onyango, and he certainly gets to join us on the show this particular afternoon. Dennis, you're most welcome to Game On Fan Friday. How are you doing? Claire, Dennis, we can't hear you. I think you should go again. How are you doing? And welcome to Game On. Sorry for that, Dennis. You should be coming back to in just a bit. We seem to have a bit of a technical glitch. But Dennis Onyango should be joining us when we come back after the break. We shall be talking to him. For now, though, let's get to that short break. You're watching Game On Fan Friday. In case you've got any questions for him, Facebook, Urban Television, Twitter, the handle is at Urban TV Uganda. But for now, let's get to that short break.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.